Hi there, my name is Dan, and this is a free extract from my larger InDesign course on my website, bringyourownlaptop.com. Howdy partners, in this video we're going to look at bringing in images and logos and rotating them, and we'll look at this one where we've cropped it. You can see, look at this, sneaky. This one's actually a little bit bigger. Okay, so we've cropped it into a nice little box. We'll flip them. We'll do all sorts of stuff with images. All right, let's go and do that now. Okay, to bring in an image, icon, or any sort of visual graphic, it's the same, okay? First thing we need to do, though, is we need to get in the habit of, if I have my black arrow selected, okay, and just click off in this dark gray area around the side here, okay, so there's nothing selected. There's a more official way. You can go to Edit and go to Deselect All, okay? It's a long way. So, we've got nothing selected, then we're going to go to File, Place. Okay, remember that's Import for InDesign. Pick the 01 Flyer folder, and there's one there called Lunch. Now your cursor is loaded, okay, with this little image, and you've got two ways of putting it in there, okay? Now when you're bringing in images into InDesign, it can confuse you when you're new. The easiest way is over here in the gray area to click once. Okay, that'll bring in my image at full size. If it's coming in too big, you can go to Edit and go to Undo Place. Okay, that kind of goes back. And what I want to do is click, hold, and drag in this gray area. And it doesn't really matter how big, you can see that's the size of my image. If it's coming through really, really big, just click and drag it out to a more appropriate size. Okay, the reason I do that is I'm going to go to Edit, Undo again. Okay, or Control Z on a Mac, or Command Z on a PC, so undone. If I click it on this green box here, the icon changes. It's a little bit hard to see. Taylor will zoom in for us so he can kind of, so you can kind of see the brackets appear. Okay, all it means is if I click on this, it's kind of merged them together. My green box is gone forever. You might want that, that's cool, so you can do that. But what I do is, I find that's always a pain. Edit, undo, undo, undo. Okay, I'm going to keep going undo until that's back. And remember, I can just click once out here in the background. Okay, let's look at some of the things we can do with images. First of all, is probably you would want to resize them. Okay, so resizing them seems easy. You grab the black arrow, you grab the corner, and you drag it up. And weirdly, it does that by default. Okay, lovely InDesign. Okay, I'm going to undo. So what we need to do is our first shortcut. We're not going to learn too many in this course. There's going to be a cheat sheet at the end for loads of shortcuts. But what we want to do is learn a couple of the more practical ones. And in this case, it's resizing an image. Okay, and you hold down on a Mac, it's Command and Shift. If you're on a PC, it's Control and Shift. Hold those two down on your keyboard. You're holding. Okay, grab this corner now and drag it up. Okay, and you see it resizes. Strange long shortcut, I know, it's just the way InDesign is, and we can resize it that way. To rotate it, there's a manual rotation at the top here, so there's a little indicator. If I need it to be 45 degrees, I can just type it in and it rotates. I'm going to undo. Okay, if you want to do it just more kind of casually, or you're just kind of playing with the design, okay, is with the same black arrow, hover, you can see on the edge here it does the resizing thing. Okay, but if I hover just a bit further out, you can see my icon changes. It's this little double-headed arrow. I can click, hold, and drag that now, and you can see it clicking, holding, and dragging, and it's more of a custom rotation. I'm going to undo that. Another thing we might do is flip it. Okay, so up the top here, so I've got it selected with my black arrow, and there's this options here that flips it horizontally. Sometimes it ends up all the way over here, and you got to click and drag it back across, and flipping it vertically. Does it up the top there as well. Okay, so I'm going to undo, 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 and we haven't got a flipped image. The next thing we're going to look at is something called the content grabber. Okay, it's this little target that appears. Now, when you're trying to just move your image around, so I need to move it down the bottom here, avoid this thing completely. Okay, so I'm going to click and drag anywhere but there, and I can move it around. If I drag this, what happens is, in InDesign, your image is actually inside a picture frame already. Okay, so they're two separate things, and you can move them individually, which is quite handy sometimes, but can be a bit annoying when you're learning. Okay, so if I click and drag this, okay, content grabber, you'll see the frame, you see him there? That's the edge of him. He's still there, but the picture within that frame has slid to the side, and that can be quite cool when you're trying to crop things, okay? And I can grab it, drag it back, okay? But I'm gonna undo a couple of times. Remember, edit, undo, okay? I'm gonna use my shortcut. So what you need to do is, if you're physically moving it, click anywhere but the target. But if you want to move it within the frame, you can drag that little content grabber and undo. If you really don't like the content grabber, secret note, I don't like it. Okay, and I turn this off. I go to view and I go to extras and I go to hide content grabber. Okay, there are other ways of cropping stuff. Up to you. Okay, you don't have to turn it off. You might love it. Lots of people do. What we're going to do now is look at some basic cropping, because what I want to do is I would like this thing, let's click, hold, and drag it so it's at least in the top right. It kind of snaps. It's pretty clever at snapping to the edges. If yours is not snapping, just double check view. There's one in here that's called smart guides. So grids and guides, smart guides, that's the thing that kind of helps it like automatically just jump to the edge, and you don't have to be like perfect, pixel perfect, it'll jump in there for you. So I want it definitely in the top right. I'm going to grab this bottom left, okay, and I'm going to hold down my shortcut to resize it. Who remembers what the shortcut was? That's right, Command Shift on a Mac and Command Shift on a PC. So I'm dragging it out. I want it to be at least or bigger than our background image, okay? So I want it snapped up in the corner there. And what I want to do is, remember if I hold those two shortcut keys down, it resizes it. But if I don't, okay, remember when I grabbed it before, kind of crops it. And that's going to work in our favor now, because what I want to do is just grab this side and maybe in the middle, okay, roughly in the middle. Okay, I want it to be like this. And same with the bottom. Okay, I'm going to drag it up so it's just on my bleed. Okay, I'm cropping bits of the image off, I know. Okay, but that's the kind of look I'm looking for. And what I also might want to do is, remember Content Grabber? I hated it, but it's kind of handy now. Look, I can drag the center of it, and you can see I can drag it within this box little bits. Okay, so let's bring in one more thing. Let's bring in the logo. Exact same technique as the image. So remember, black arrow, click in the background so you got nothing selected. Go to File. Let's go to Place. And pick one of the logos. I'm going to use this first one, Logo 1 Full. It doesn't have to be a JPEG or a PNG. It can be an Illustrator file, which is another Adobe product. Let's click Open. Okay, and remember, in this gray area in the background, click once, or you can click and drag to get the size that you want. Okay, and black arrow, grab anywhere but the content grabber. Remember, if I try moving that center bit, weirdly, the image is over here, but the frame is still over here. So I'm going to undo that. Click off in the background, and I'm going to grab anywhere but the content grabber. Okay, and I'm going to stick it there somewhere. That's my lovely logo. Earlier I said, you remember you have to have nothing selected, okay? I'll show you the reason why is, if I have this green box selected by accident and I want to bring in my logo, let's say it's before I brought in this logo, okay? Actually, I'll delete it to make it. So I've got this green box selected, File, and I've forgotten to deselect it, go to Place, and I go my logo, and I click Open. It doesn't give me the option of like dragging it out and giving it a size. It just kind of like fuses it with this green box, which is cool, but it's kind of stuck there now, okay? There are one in the same. Okay, so I'm going to undo until life was easier. So remember, before you bring it in, just deselect in the background and then go to File, Place. All right, my friends, that is working with images. Let's go on and start working with type in InDesign. So what did you think? Did you like it? Okay, if you did, please hit the like button and maybe consider subscribing to my channel. It really helps my business. Now, this is just a free video from my larger InDesign course. You can see the full version on bringyourownlaptop.com. On that site, there is a free cheat sheet you can download. Okay, print it off, stick it next to your computer, look awesome. The other thing is I have lots of other courses there. Photoshop, Illustrator, InDesign, After Effects, Premiere, Dreamweaver, lots of other ones. So go check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. Bye.